In a move that surprises absolutely no one, the NHL is doubling down on bad decisions. Hello everyone and welcome, my name is Sammy Flair, and today we're going to be talking about the NHL doubling down and banning Pride tape during warmups. A quick little look back in history. Back in June, the NHL announced that NHL teams would no longer be participating in themed nights, at least not on the ice. The short version is that every team has themed nights throughout the season, like Hockey Fights Cancer and Military Appreciation Night and Pride Night, where they wear themed jerseys only for warmups, and in the case of Pride tape, rainbow colored stick tape for warmups. Again, they're not actually playing with these on the ice. You can get my thoughts on that initial decision from this video that I recorded back in June. Link is up there if you want to watch. On the surface, I really didn't understand. No, that's not true. I understood the decision that the NHL made, but in my opinion, it was a severe overcorrection. The only reason that these things came up was because I think a handful, maybe a total of 7 players throughout the entire league made headlines, made a little bit of a fuss about not wearing a Pride-themed jersey, about not putting rainbow color tape on their sticks for the sake of warmups. And look, I'll be perfectly honest with you, I don't think that any player should be forced to do anything that they're uncomfortable with. Will I have a little bit of a difference of opinion from them? Absolutely. And when it came to players that were citing their religious beliefs as a defense for that, I'm certainly going to have more things to say about that in particular. But the reason I say that it's an overcorrection is, well, the NHL had a very easy choice that they could have made there. They could have said, look, we officially side with players that do not want to participate in this. It is not mandatory that they wear the jersey or express themselves in this way if they're not comfortable with it. We give players the opportunity to do as they please. And yes, those players are still likely to come under some level of scrutiny from the media, from the fan bases, from the rest of their team. But I mean, at the end of the day, none of us are in the locker rooms with these players. We don't truly know what's going on. We don't know the conversations that are being had. We don't know if the team is giving players the option to opt out of supporting things that they may not be in favor of. But the ball was teed up for Gary Bettman. He had a wide open field in front of him. And when given that opportunity, what did he do? He decided to stand on the other side of the ball and, with all of his crusty old man might, hit the ball as far as he could in the opposite direction. And the NHL essentially banned all of those things from being on ice participation. So you're not any longer going to see players warming up in Hockey Fights Cancer jerseys, military appreciation jerseys, Hispanic heritage jerseys, indigenous peoples jerseys, nothing of that sort, including the fun ones that, like the Tampa Bay Gasparilla jerseys, those don't even get to be included. The NHL was essentially trying to say that players could still participate in this off ice and they could model the jerseys and take pictures and they could sign them, but it's not the same thing. And look, I will say this again later in the video, but if you don't understand why it's not the same thing, if you don't have to worry about that kind of representation in a meaningful way, these initiatives, these inclusive initiatives, they're not meant for you. But all of that leads us to just a couple days ago before the NHL season kicked off, and the NHL sent memos to teams officially announcing what they can and cannot do as part of these theme celebration nights, and made a special point to include that the NHL is banning the use of Pride tape during warmups. Okay, perhaps that's not fair. Maybe it's not one specifically that's being called out in the memo, but it is one that's being heavily implied, and it's the one that's being discussed the most often. Now look, there are a lot of angles to approach this from, and I have a lot of thoughts concerning it. The first of which being that I'm not terribly surprised that this happened. I kinda already thought that this was implied with the initial decision, so I read it and I'm like, okay, yeah, I guess that makes sense. But there's this niggling doubt in the back of my head that says this is probably a more targeted clarification rather than anything. If the NHL is gonna keep up its stance and have a backbone for once about doing the things that they intend to do, then this initiative does need to be applied to every potential theme night that a team may go through. And if that's the case, then why does it need to be called out that rainbow pride tape in particular is the thing that's being banned? Look, at its most basic issue, we know exactly why this is happening. LGBTQ everything is a divisive issue in every realm of human culture right now, including sports. For as many supporters and allies as the LGBTQ community will have in sports, between the players and the coaches and the management and the organization, the social media team, the everything, you are still always going to have dissenters. You are still going to have people that are upset about the representation and that they feel that politics and sexuality and gender identity should be kept out of sports. And the unfortunate thing is those people tend to be the loudest, and the people that are loudest tend to complain the most, and the people that are the loudest and tend to complain the most, unfortunately, get their way much of the time. And for those people that do feel that way, the people that want to remove even discussions about gender and sexuality and everything else from the realm of sports, my response is simple. You're clearly not paying attention to the world around you. Look, the simple fact of the matter is that these issues need to be discussed out in the open within the context of the NHL teams, within the context of the NHL as a league. Whether you want to admit it or not, there is a high likelihood that on every single team, there is a member of the LGBTQ community. Now, it may not necessarily be a player. It may not necessarily be a coach, but it could be someone in management. It could be somebody in ownership. It could be somebody who's a part-time employee at the arena that they play at. You just don't know. But to sit here and say that you want all of those issues to be disconnected from the sport, that you don't want that representation, it means you are not paying attention to the world around you. And in some cases, you may not be paying attention to the players that you root for. I'm not here to cause more controversy or divisiveness or anything else like that. But what I will say is essentially a repetition of what I've already said. You can't take these things out of sport because the people that it matters to are already involved in the sport. I think what may be the most puzzling and frustrating for me in this entire conversation is the NHL is a league that has made in the past significant strides towards better representation, towards better diversity and equality and equity and all the words that people want to convince you are naughty words that only belong in politics. It was the NHL in the first place that decided that these initiatives can and should exist. And again, that's not just a pride thing. That applies to Hockey Fights Cancer. It applies to military appreciation and representation of people groups within the United States and Canada. It was originally the NHL that partnered with the You Can Play Project for the last decade or so, an organization that is committed to LGBTQ inclusion in the realm of sports. In fact, that's where you get this tagline of hockey is for everyone from. The NHL did do that. They engaged with that. And it looked like it was going well for a while. It looked like the NHL was making significant strides towards reaching that goal of inclusivity and diversity and all the things that make the human race so wonderful at times and so divisive at others. But at the end of the day, it's still a human issue. And that's really at the core of this. It's a human issue. As soon as you are discussing something that has a legitimate effect on somebody else's life, it has become a human issue. And when you exhibit a lack of humanity, a lack of compassion and empathy for your fellow human beings, you've already started down a bad path. And so it looks like the NHL is essentially walking back on all the progress that they've made, all for the sake of what? Because seven players in the league made a fuss about not wearing a pride jersey. I don't care if they wear the pride jersey. I don't care if they have the pride tape on. It's their right as an American and as part of the team to either opt into the celebration or to not do that. And instead of giving players that option, the NHL just essentially said, nah, we're not going to discuss that at all. We're not going to let this ruin our perfectly good hockey season. So yeah, nobody's allowed to do it. No more fun. No more expressing yourself. None of that. Yeah, get out of here. And part of the frustration is I know that there are solid allies in every team in the league and even within the league itself. It doesn't mean that your favorite hockey player is going to put on a pride jersey and immediately become gay. It doesn't mean that your favorite coach is going to put on a pride jersey or hat or anything like that and all of a sudden they're a non-binary person. It doesn't work like that. Let me just say this one more time and I'll do my best to be perfectly clear about it. If you don't understand why these nights matter, whether it's hockey is for everyone, whether it's hockey fights cancer or military appreciation or indigenous people's heritage or Hispanic heritage or anything else where there is a legitimate community that has been ignored or marginalized or anything else, if you do not understand why that representation matters, then it is not meant for you. And if you fall into that category, genuinely, from the bottom of my heart, congratulations. I am thrilled for you because it means that you have never had to worry about being represented or in many cases misrepresented in any social space that you have ever been in. But you cannot afford to be that blind. You cannot possibly afford to say, well, this is the way I live life, so why does it matter that this person over here gets their own special night at this sporting event? Why can't they just be happy with going to see the game like I do? You know what? That's a decent enough question, so let me address it. Every year, I do my best to go to at least one NHL game. I usually aim for a handful, but I'll settle for one, usually when my team comes into town. I've witnessed firsthand, people get into fights for trivial reasons because somebody said something stupid that another person didn't like. And let us not forget that it was only 5 years ago that at a Chicago Blackhawks and Washington Capitals game, Devontae Smith-Pelly, a player, may I remind you, a player on the ice, was inundated as being the subject of racist taunts and comments from the stands, from fans. And you hear about it because, well, a player was involved and cameras are going to pick up on that. Of course, people are going to make a big deal of that. So what happens when these kind of issues arise and when these kind of comments are made in the upper deck, in the nosebleed seats, where there are no cameras, so you're not going to get the attention on it, where all you have around you are fans, normal everyday people that may actually just kind of despise your very being. In my experience of going to games since coming out, it essentially means that I never truly feel comfortable in an arena. It means I truly never feel welcome, and I always have to wonder about the people that are around me. And when you're constantly worrying about that, it means that you don't get to give yourself over to the game and enjoy it in ways that you typically would. It means that I'm much more reserved about jumping up and celebrating and high-fiving people when my team scores because, oh, all of a sudden now I'm drawing attention to myself and somebody who just had a really bad day or really just hates transgender people, maybe they're waiting for me. I don't know. Is that more often than not in my mind as a perceived threat rather than a realistic one? Yeah, a lot of times it most likely is, but does that mean it's not a potential reality? Absolutely freaking not. But it matters because for that one night during the season, I get to walk into an arena and be filled with this sense that there is a welcome space for me, that it is an accepting space. And so me, I read up on what the NHL has done, and I kind of treat it as the league is giving me and the rest of the LGBTQ community a middle finger. And unfortunately, there's not much that I as a fan can do to change it, besides making a video like this, and hopefully it gets seen by people who make these kind of decisions. But in the meantime, the onus is gonna fall on the players, on the coaches, on the management to speak up and to represent us in spaces where we are currently not, and to help smooth this entire controversy over. And at least for the time being, it looks like that thing is actually going to happen. Brian Burke is a big recognizable name in the NHL. He was a former president of the Toronto Maple Leafs and the Calgary Flames. He's the current president of the Professional Women's Hockey League Player Association, and he's been a longtime advocate of the LGBTQ community. He said in a statement on his social media, "This is not inclusion or progress. Fans look to teams and the league to show they are welcome, and this directive closes a door that's been open for the last decade. Make no mistake, this is a surprising and serious setback." And Brian Burke is one voice, admittedly a very big voice, in the midst of a slowly growing number of voices that are entering the conversation and expressing displeasure in how the NHL is handling this. Other names that I've seen so far are Derek Lalonde, the coach of the Detroit Red Wings, and Scott Laughton, the center for the Philadelphia Flyers. As a fan, I kind of want the stars to really step up in this league. I don't care necessarily who they are. I would imagine Connor McDavid will have something to say about this, as he did during the NHL Player Awards. Same goes for Steven Stamkos. Is simply speaking out for it going to be enough for the NHL to do something about it? Probably not. I sincerely hope that no matter how many players it is, somebody takes the stand and basically defies the NHL's directive. Like, they'll take on the fine or whatever punishment comes down as a result of it. In a tweet from Alan Walsh, who is a NHL player agent, he says, quote, "Hearing many players are planning to give the middle finger to Gary," that is Gary Bettman, commissioner of the NHL, "by supporting special initiatives, including military appreciation, first responders, people of color, indigenous communities, pride, among others. Players should be free to express themselves or not as they choose." How is that going to look? I genuinely don't know. Maybe these players do actually give Gary a middle finger. That would be funny. Maybe the players defy the directive in totality, and maybe they wear the jersey for warm-up regardless. And maybe they put the tape on their sticks regardless. And my hope would be that in that scenario, the team, the organization itself, would front the fine for those players. Even if not, let's be real, a lot of the players that will do this are going to be happy to pay that fine. And as far as I know, we don't know what the consequences for defying the directive actually are. So who knows what might actually come of this? I guess we're going to have to wait and see how all of this ends up playing out. A lot of the theme nights for teams should be kicking off soon, probably late October, early November, and they'll run through March or something like that. So the conversation will be ongoing, and it might be a developing story. A story is a very nice word to say. I think it's going to be more like controversy. And I'm going to pay attention to it as closely as I possibly can, especially as I'm covering the Lightning for this season. I'm going to be very interested to see how that organization responds, how the players handle it, how they respond. It'll be a whole thing. I'm sure this is not the last video I'm going to make on Pride Night and Pride Tape and just this entire stupid freaking whatever it is has been thrown down onto the league this year. Thank you, Gary. And now that I'm good and worked up, I'm going to end this video before I say something stupid. So thank you so much for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. Thank you for giving me some of your time. Let me know your thoughts. Let me know if I'm overreacting to any of this in some way. Let me know if you have a different opinion. I always welcome conversation in the comment section. Just keep it civil. But until I see you next time, go Bolts. And let's really hope that the team makes good decisions around all of this nonsense. I'm so tired of it. We'll be right back.